to Republicans they have relationships with, trying to get them on board with this impeachment resolution, trying to almost implore them to try and punish the president in some way, shape, or form, and relying on something, Kate, that I've heard repeatedly from members in both chambers, members from both parties over the course of the last 24 hours, just how much it's sinking in. As each day goes on, we talked about it yesterday too, as you see more of the videos, as you recognize the real threat, as you recognize how much danger these lawmakers were in, hoping that that helps persuade Republicans to come on board. We'll see what happens when they vote. They've got the votes. They will impeach the president on Wednesday, exactly 7 days after they were attacked in the U.S. Capitol, Kate.
Phil, thank you so much. A lot is going to be happening. We're going to get back to Phil and the Hill in just a second. So President Trump, he is emerging from hiding for the first time since inciting the deadly Capitol Hill riots. And some of the first words out of his mouth are, it's all a hoax. Nothing has changed with him. He's going to Alamo, Texas, to visit the border wall. Jeremy Diamond is there, and he's joining us right now. So, Jeremy, what is this all about? He did face reporters, did not sound like he took any questions. What did he say?
Yeah, what we heard from the president was making very clear that he has no regrets about the comments that he made to those thousands of supporters of his who went on to storm the Capitol last Wednesday. The president insisting that he bears no responsibility for their actions and insisting that his words were perfect, much in the same way that he claimed that his call with the Ukrainian president, that was a perfect call before he was impeached for that call. The president now, as he faces his second impeachment, making very similar claims. Listen to what he said as he left Washington.
It's been analyzed, and people thought that what I said was totally appropriate. And if you look at what other people have said, politicians at a high level, about the riots during the summer, the horrible riots in Portland and Seattle and various other places, that was a real problem, what they said. But they've analyzed my speech and my words and my final paragraph, my final sentence, and everybody to the T thought it was totally appropriate.
Now, what the president is saying there is just completely untrue. In fact, many people have analyzed his words during that rally before that riot took place on Capitol Hill. Legal experts, in fact, who have said that they believe that the president has legal exposure for what he said there, that he helped incite this riot on Capitol Hill, incite this insurrection that we saw on Capitol Hill last Wednesday. The president, at the same time, insisting today that he wants no violence from his supporters, but he did offer somewhat of a warning. Perhaps some will interpret it as a threat when he said that the effort to impeach him a second time is causing tremendous anger and tremendous danger, representing tremendous danger for lawmakers in Washington. Those words, quite remarkable, coming from the president, and clearly he is not chastened. And instead, as you said, Kate, he is expected to come here today. We are near Alamo, Texas, where the president is expected to come visit the border wall to mark the completion of more than 450 miles of wall, trying to change the conversation clearly from what is happening back in Washington and tout one of his signature accomplishments. But even that accomplishment, Kate, we should note, fell short of what the president campaigned on. He said that they would be building 1,000 miles of border wall. Clearly, he fell short of that goal. And also, Mexico still has not paid for the wall. Instead, taxpayers bearing the brunt of billions of dollars of construction. Kate?
I'm sorry, I just can't get past this. The fact that the president even would pretend to say that people think that it's appropriate, he said to a T, thinks what he said was appropriate. I can assure you, if you have a brain in your head, and I know you all do, I can assure you from the highest levels of the federal government, they don't agree. That is a lie. They put this at the feet of the president, and I'm sorry, but that is a lie, and he is delusional to say so still in public. Because, as we know, words matter. People who were at the Capitol said they went to the Capitol because the president told him to. I'm sorry, Jeremy. Thank you very much for your fantastic
report. And there's a reason why we are seeing so many Republicans calling for his resignation.
Absolutely. Let's see if they step up and we'll move to impeach. Appreciate it. Let's get back.